So in true wiki style, we sort of crowdsourced some questions for you, and here's about 10 of them that popped up. First one on Twitter, Carl Dietrich asks, what is a fact?
What is a fact? Well, that's a very interesting question. For me, a fact is a statement about reality that corresponds to reality. In the Wikipedia context, I suppose, and probably more driving at what someone's asking is, the difference between a fact and an opinion. For us, one of the most important things is to look for reliable sources and to report accurately on what reliable sources have said, rather than just say, well, gee, I think this is true, I'm going to write it down. That's never quite enough for us.
Okay. Metasonics on Twitter asked, Jimmy, why does Wikipedia have 4,046 articles about Doctor Who but only 1,020 articles about William Shakespeare?
Well, first of all, there have been many, many more Doctor Who episodes than Shakespeare plays. And I say that as a half a joke, but it is actually the case that for sort of a very long-running series like Doctor Who, there's a lot to write about. But it does get at the same diversity question that I was speaking of earlier, that people write about what they're passionate about, what they know about, and there's a lot of really amazing Doctor Who fans out there who have documented the series in incredible detail, and I think that's wonderful. I think the slight implicit fallacy in the question is that somehow if we devoted less resources to Doctor Who, we would have more stuff. People say this, a slightly better example might be Pokemon.
Right.
And I always say, do you really want those Pokemon authors, as much as I love them, writing about mm-hmm. Shakespeare? And the answer is probably not. They don't know much about Shakespeare. So people should write what they know about, and we would love to get more Shakespeare scholars to come and help.
Okay, at Synaptic Sync asks, would Jimmy Wales or Wiki ever consider a Wiki Junior for kids?
It's an idea that's been bounced around a lot over the years, and it's just something that it turns out to be very, very difficult. There's a lot of reasons for it, questions about what's appropriate for children, what's not appropriate for children, that makes it tough. Another question is, at what age level of children are we talking about? A Wiki Junior for 6-year-olds or 10-year-olds or 14-year-olds, they're all going to be very, very different, and also for many of us who I more or less know how to write for other adults. We just assume that you're basically high school to college educated. I can write for you. I'm not sure how to write for a 6-year-old. It's been a while since I had one, you know.
Right. Marson Moose, I think this is on Google Plus, asks, how did you get such a piercing stare whenever you do those ads at the top of pages that cut right through my soul?
Oh, I don't know. You know, it's interesting.
You can just shoot one to the camera and we'll call it even.
I hope they caught that. It's interesting because I really wish that I weren't on the banners, or certainly not on there as much. A couple years ago when we started doing that, the staff came to me and said, can we put your picture in the banner? And I was like, oh, really? I don't know. And they said, can we test it at least? And so we tested it and it performed twice as well as anything else that we tested. And so we've been testing. Last year, we found this great guy, Brandon, one of our developers. His ad performed as well as I did. We were very excited about that. This year, we're doing filming of something like 100 Wikipedia volunteers, and we're going to test a lot of them, and hopefully we'll find something that works better so that, I'm not the only one staring at everybody.
From Facebook, Chris Schwert, I'm curious what your thoughts are on the reputation of Wikipedia as a resource source. I know my college professors had very low opinion of the site and would judge harshly any student who used it as a direct reference. Does he agree with these professors' attitudes, or does he think that Wikipedia's reputation among academics is incorrect?
Well, I think the reputation among academics has improved dramatically. I think that, in general, professors are coming to grips with the new world and coming to grips with Wikipedia, and also the quality has improved dramatically. Mm-hmm. At the same time, as I mentioned earlier, I don't think at a university level it makes sense to cite any encyclopedia in an academic paper. That's just not what an encyclopedia's role is in the research process. Maybe if you're in junior high, you know, if some kid out there is 12 years old and they wrote something and they put in a footnote, we should be thrilled, right? That's the first start on the idea of crediting other people with ideas and things like that. But at the university level, no, it's a bit junior high to cite an encyclopedia.
Oliver Stein on Google Plus asks, how does he see Wikipedia developing over the next decade, and does he have any other projects in the works?
So over the next decade, there's two elements, I think. One, we're going to see a lot of changes to the editing interface to make it easier for people to use. I think that's going to be quite evident. In terms of the reading interface, I don't anticipate a lot of changes. I mean, it works perfectly well, and that's great. The other big change change that is going to be invisible to most people, at least most English speakers, is the incredible growth that we're experiencing and expect to experience in all the languages of the developing world. You know, one of my favorite examples, the Kazakh Wikipedia is just booming and doing great. That's very exciting, and it's something most people won't notice, but the global nature of Wikipedia is really fundamental to how we think about our success.
We've got a question from Larry Sanger, who asks, why does Wikipedia represent itself as being appropriate for kids when it also hosts completely unfiltered pornography?
Well, this is a very difficult question for us, and we do get this question from a lot of different people. The real question is, how do you define what is pornography? Where do we cross the line? We try not to cross the line. But the truth is, if you're going to have a comprehensive encyclopedia for adults, you're going to cover some topics that are quite about sexuality and things like that, they're quite difficult. We are going to host some images that some people are going to find uncomfortable. And it's not just about porn. It's about images of violence, you know, historical images, things like that. In our community, we have an ongoing discussion about this. We try to be responsible. We try to be thoughtful. One of the things I always say is that if your kid is on the internet and they look up some sexual term, I think you would much rather them find Wikipedia's very dry and dull discussion and explanation than to find a million and one porn sites out there. So I think that we have to consider this in the full context. I think we could do a better job, but here we are.
And they also ask, how many articles have you ever started on Wikipedia?
I've started a few. I'm not a big article starter. I started one about a scientist who found a bird, and I thought, you know, there's a bird, something, a woodpecker, I believe it was, that was thought to be extinct, but he found one.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, wow, we don't even have an article about this guy. I started writing it thinking, well, this will be completely uncontroversial. Turns out it's a raging controversy as to whether the bird was actually found or not. So
okay.
That was sort of an amusing experience. Mainly, I do editing to existing articles, but I am active as an editor.
Okay.
And my specialty, for some unknown reason, is the UK House of Lords. So that's what I write about.
Right. Number nine, are your volunteer article writers given any kind of background checks? How do we know they're reliable?
No, they're not. I mean, anyone can turn up and start editing. And so the reliability of the site is a function of the process of cross-checking, of people looking up, checking on each other's work, debating, discussing. My view is that the best way to achieve quality is to get as many eyes on the problem as possible. And so rather than what I would call a gatekeeper model, which means we're going to check people before they're allowed to do something, it's an accountability model, saying once you've done something, we're going to check your work.
And finally, Sergio Emanuel on Google Plus asks, without elaborating, is this sustainable? Why not place an ad for each wiki article? Would that be against your principles? Won't that help financially in a big way? What's the future for Wikipedia aside from articles?
Yeah, so our financial model, we think, is sustainable. We're organized as a charity, so we're a 501c3 nonprofit organization. People can donate money to us. We had our best fundraiser ever last year, and we're expecting to have an even better one coming up this fall. And yeah, we could bring in a lot of money through advertising, but for me, it's just not right for Wikipedia. It's for me, Wikipedia, I call it, and sometimes people chuckle at my expression, but a temple for the mind. It's a place to go to be thoughtful, to think, to reflect, to learn. I'm not at all anti-commerce. I'm not at all anti-advertising. I just think there are places where it's good and places where it's not good.
Great. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.